Welcome to today's video. It's a little bit different. I'm sitting down, which is not something I normally do, at least on the ground on the channel. Today's video is sponsored by NewAir. They have so graciously sent me a product to review. So today I am reviewing the new, to them, single tap Kegerator. So let's go ahead and get started. All right, so we're gonna start at the beginning of this thing with the unboxing to all the specs to everything you need to know about it. So I'll first tell you, opening and getting it out of the box, super easy. If you've ever bought a refrigerator of any sort, they are normally pretty smart about how they package it. You normally just open up a few things and the box just comes right off. So the packaging was really nice. I unboxed it super quick, pulled it out. And when I did, I first wanna note it comes with like these singular wheels that are just, I don't know what the proper term is, but it only comes with two wheels and then it has the pegs to adjust the level. So if you just want it to stand without any wheels, you have that, or it comes with actual casters. And so the first thing I did was I unboxed it. I pulled everything out, which we'll talk about what was in it. And I went ahead and put those casters on. So it's currently setting on wheels right now, which means it's easy to move around, which is nice. Put it back up, and of course, now we get to talk about what came with it. Here are all the things that come with this Kegerator. It comes with a CO2 regulator, a CO2 tank, not filled. It is a 5-pound tank. It is not filled. Obviously, you can't ship a filled tank. It also comes with the, connection's already done. So basically all I had to do was attach the tower with some screws, which I'll show that in a moment. And it was ready to go, very simply. It also comes with some shelving, which I don't currently have in it. I'll show in a moment. This is the shelving that comes with it. I haven't even taken the tag off of that. So if you wanted to use this for as just like a normal fridge and put things in it, and it does come with a mount for the CO2 tank, which there are two. So let me show you what's happening in here. Okay, so I just went ahead and pulled it out, but just a moment ago, I had a 5-gallon corny keg in there, and I currently have this 3-gallon keg sitting in here. So this is what's going on with this. This is a different CO2 tank that I have. It comes with a 5-pound tank. And this is my 2.5-pound that I've used for some other stuff. So it does come with a 5-pound tank. This little white thing here is for holding the tank in place, which is very nice. The connections are a little bit different, and I'll explain why here in just a moment. But essentially you have enough space to fit up to 2 5-gallon like Cornelius kegs, or you could do the larger 1.6¼ kegs, which the connections are actually graded for that. And again, I'll explain in a moment. But so this is the bottom half of it. This is everything that's going on. The interior is really nice. You have a nice light that comes on, of course. So, you know, if you're ever doing something in the dark, you need to see. There is a really nice strip here that is where you control your temperature. You can go Fahrenheit or Celsius. You can go as high as, what's the lowest point? So it goes from 32 Fahrenheit to 70 Fahrenheit. So almost to freezing, pretty much. There is shelving spots here. So that shelving I showed earlier, you can slide in as you need it. Obviously, when you have kegs and stuff in here that take up space, you can't really fit it into there, which is, normal, understandable. So now let's talk about the top. So here we have the tower. This is, of course, where everything is routed through. This is a single tower, obviously one tap. The tap itself is really, really nice. And I'm gonna go ahead and get a pour of some mead, show ya. This is my apple and cinnamon mead. And as you can see, it's very, very nice. One thing I do like about this tap is that I'll show you real fast. I'm just gonna push it out back in. It kind of has a safeguard in that you can't just press it and walk away. Sometimes keg taps will just stay, and then if somebody is not paying attention, you'll lose a whole gallon of things. So This tower is super nice. It does come with a drip tray, so slides in right there. This is the guardrails for it. Overall, this thing looks super, super nice and sleek, and it is like a plastic material up here. Of course, there are some metal bits, but it's pretty sturdy, and I quite like it. So I talked about a couple connections a few minutes ago, and this thing, the connections they give you when you first get it are for those quarter and six barrel kegs, meaning that it looks a little different. This is a quarter or six barrel keg connection. So it's got its gas line right here, which is what this blue it goes to. This is for your gas, it connects to here. And then there is a different kind of connection that goes to the actual liquid. So what I had to do to adjust this to work for Cornelius kegs, I had to take and snip the line that was routed already through the tower and essentially just convert it to a Cornelius tap. So all I did was this was part of the attached line, and I just snipped it and redid my connections. A little bit different than obviously the quarter keg. I'm gonna keep this around because one day if I decide to get a large barrel keg of sorts, then I need this. The only hard part will be if I ever want to put this connection back on, I'm going to have to run a new connection up to the tap, which will be a little bit tricky, but at this current venture, I have a bunch of corny kegs, 5 gallon corny kegs and a 3 gallon keg, so I don't really need this, but it does come with this if you are a barrel keg kind of person. I had to do the same kind of adjustment to the gas line. Really pretty simple. If you've done much with kegging, I'm not gonna go too deep in the kegging side on how to keg exactly because that goes real deep. This is just a overview of this product itself. So after a few weeks of using this and having experience in kegging now, this thing itself is super, super nice. And I've been mega impressed with it. It's very, I mean, it's pretty dang quiet. Obviously when you open the door, it does get a little louder. But that's sort of to be expected because, I mean, ultimately the fan has to run. So the interior of this is very nice. It is its normal, like kind of fridge-like material, insulated really well. It shipped totally fine. I was very impressed with that. I just took it out of the box and everything was great. I'm a big fan of it. And I think for this price point, you are getting a very good deal. The only thing you don't get with this is you don't get a keg of any sort, which is fine. If you were smart like me, you can get access to a good keg for pretty cheap. So for example, this right here, roll back my way. I'm not used to sitting and doing videos like this. So this little Cornelius keg, I got it on a deal, 5 gallon. This was $35 for this keg, for 5 gallon keg. You can find a good deal on kegs online. You just have to do a little research. So the temperature gauge is really nice, easily controllable. The overall equipment is really good as well. I'm mega impressed with that. Of course, having your CO2 tank provided is very nice. I see no reason to not get this thing. Especially with it coming with a regulator, that's pretty nice. The regulators can be sort of expensive, so it's nice to get that. Overall, I am very impressed with this product and I think you should go and purchase it. And like I said, I'm sponsored by NewAir for this. So if you want to use my code or use my link, they'll be down in the description or down right here. And that will help the channel. It'll help give you, helps the channel grow. So thank you to NewAir for sponsoring this video. I've had a lot of fun getting to review this thing and I highly suggest you go check it out. This is the new product for them and they've already knocked it out of the park with their first time. So I have enjoyed this a lot. I hope you will check them out and I hope you have a great day. So with that, cheers.